last time I hated maths, I don't like maths, but ever since I joined this class, I really feel the urge to like learn more things about maths.
Before, I wasn't like a bit shy when I was told to go up in front of the class to tell a story, something like that. But after this lesson, it like boosts off my guts. I dare to stand in front of like the whole school or sometimes even.
I learned to respect others by not putting down on them. Then we'll encourage each other. Then by doing that, we'll also help each other on our studies.
Who says studying has to be boring? In line with the Education Ministry's move towards a more well-rounded, student-centric education, Razor TV visits three schools to find out how they put the fun back in class. The first is Bedok South Secondary School. Teachers here conduct English and mathematics lessons using activity-based projects and real-life situations to make learning enjoyable for the students.
For the lower sec normal tech, we have this skills and ability period where it's actually the school actually created a white space for teachers to actually conduct a non-routine lesson, a non-routine activities. So for example, actually is the learning journey that we conduct for our pupils at least once a semester. And one which is the one that they are doing now is actually the maths project, Design Your Room. Yeah. So in addition to that, as part of the lesson actually, we also brought them to IKEA for a learning journey because it's all about furniture, budgeting, estimation. So what they are doing actually, we are gearing more towards life skills, equipping them with basic numeracy skills. They have a hands-on experience on budgeting, estimation.
This is different from my primary school class because it's like, at primary school, we don't always go out, and we like studying very boring. But here is like we can go out with friends and understand more about them.
The mid-year exam we failed a bit. Then after that we and SA2 we have improved a lot.
Yeah. Most of the class.
The teachers have taught us useful, and we understand.
Over at Jurongville Secondary School, students participate in daily exercise with their form teachers as part of their curriculum to learn about teamwork and build student-teacher relationship.
I think through sports, students are able to interact more with each other outside the classroom, and there's also greater teacher-student relationship that is built in the classroom as well. And they also learn things like social-emotional competencies and they are more respectful to each other.
We can increase the bonding with the teachers, then it also helps us to respect the students and communicate with them more.
Another key area MOE is focusing on is reaching out to parents. At Fairfield Methodist Secondary School, a group of parent volunteers have been playing an active role in running school events and programs for the students.
We started this place called T-Zone. We name it T-Zone. T stands for teens. All right, and so it's a place where we set up the cafe. So the student comes in 1 week, 3 times, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and they stay. It's open for about 2 hours. The reason is we can keep them here so that they don't go to the arcade. We befriend them for some of them if they are just, alone. Sometimes they do share their problem. Yeah. But it's also a place for the parents to network together.
What we have found is that the parents are want to be involved in the school, but I think they are very discerning. So they want to be where perhaps their support can make the most difference. And so far what we have seen is not so much in the classroom itself. I think what they have really enjoyed is being present and joining in some of these co-curricular activities. So we extend invitation to them to join us for activities like our cross-country, our Teachers' Day celebrations.
For more on the Education Ministry's new initiatives, watch our other clips.